In 1998, a 9-year-old, Netta Engelhardt, had recently moved with her family to Boston. New to America and not yet fluent in English, she worked her way through Stephen Hawking's A Brief History of Time. For many, the book is a notoriously challenging introduction to the cosmos. For Engelhardt, it was a map to her own future. The pages illuminated the grandest questions of existence, from the birth of the universe to the enigmatic nature of black holes. It was here that she first encountered the central paradox of modern physics, a deep, persistent conflict between the universe's two great theories, general relativity and quantum mechanics, that Hawking himself had authored. The book did not contain the solution, only the magnificent contours of the problem, but it was enough. As she would later recall in an interview with MIT News, where does the universe come from? What are the fundamental building blocks? Those are questions, she realized, she just wanted to know the answer to. And from that point on, she wasn't just set on physics. She was set on quantum gravity at 9. This early encounter set the trajectory of a career. Engelhardt, now a physicist at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, or MIT, has become a leading figure in a new generation of thinkers who have, in the last several years, sought to solve one of the greatest paradoxes in physics. Even at a young age, she has already made discoveries that led her to win the prestigious New Horizons in Physics Prize, also known as the Oscars of Science, and the Gribov Medal. After her family's move to Boston, a move prompted in part by her mother's visiting scholar position in linguistics at MIT, Engelhardt pursued her burgeoning passion for the fundamental laws of nature. She attended Brandeis University, where she laid the groundwork for her future inquiries by double majoring in physics and mathematics, graduating in 2011. For her doctoral studies, she was drawn to the University of California, Santa Barbara, a renowned hub for research in string theory and gravitational physics. There, under the guidance of prominent theorist Gary Horowitz, she began to dig into the deep geometric questions at the heart of the information paradox. Netta's approach to physics is to look for the weak points. A lot of my work now is going into understanding how many pillars of gravitational physics are just not true as we currently understand them, she said in an interview with MIT News. She is drawn to the field's great contradictions, seeing them not as obstacles, but as opportunities. A paradox, for her, is a map that points to a flaw in the foundations of what is known. This fascination with challenging problems drew her to what is known as the information paradox, or Hawking paradox, identified by legendary physicist Stephen Hawking. In 1974, Stephen Hawking performed a calculation that shook the foundations of physics. He applied the rules of quantum mechanics to the curved space-time just outside a black hole's event horizon, its boundary of no return, and discovered that black holes are not truly black. They glow faintly with a thermal energy that has since been named Hawking radiation. This glow means they have a temperature, and anything with a temperature must eventually radiate all its energy away, shrinking over immense time scales until it evaporates into nothing. This evaporation created a problem, the black hole information paradox. The conflict arises from a direct collision between two pillars of physics. On one side stands quantum mechanics, whose laws have been well tested. A core tenet of the quantum world is unitarity, the principle that information about the present state of a system is never truly lost. It can be scrambled, hidden, or impossibly difficult to decode, but it must, in principle, be preserved. Imagine you had a diary and you set it on fire in the lab. According to unitarity, if you knew the fundamental dynamics of the universe, you could take the ashes and reverse engineer them to see the diary and its contents. The story is still there, just written in a language of smoke and ash. On the other side is general relativity, Einstein's theory of gravity, which describes black holes as cosmic prisons. Anything that crosses the event horizon, a star, a planet, a diary, is pulled inexorably toward a central singularity, a point of infinite density where the laws of physics break down. The information contained within that object, according to relativity, is severed from the outside universe forever. Hawking's calculation brought these two theories into open war. He found that the radiation leaking from a black hole is purely thermal, meaning it is random and carries no information about what fell in. A black hole formed from a collapsed star would radiate in exactly the same way as one formed from a trillion encyclopedias. When the black hole finally vanishes, the information it consumed appears to vanish with it, violating the quantum mandate of unitarity. For nearly half a century, physicists were left with an impossible choice. Either quantum mechanics was wrong or general relativity. The physics community did not stand still. The paradox was too fundamental to ignore, as its resolution was seen as a necessary signpost on the path to a unified theory of quantum gravity. Early proposed solutions were often unsatisfying. One idea posited that a black hole might not evaporate completely, leaving behind a tiny, information-rich remnant. But this raised more questions than it answered, and there was no accepted mechanism that would halt the process of evaporation. The first conceptual breakthrough emerged from a radical new perspective on space itself. In the 1990s, physicists Gerard T. Hooft and Leonard Susskind formulated the holographic principle. They were inspired by the thermodynamics of black holes, which showed that the amount of information a black hole can contain, its entropy is proportional not to its volume, but to the surface area of its event horizon. This was a startling discovery. It suggested that the information describing a three-dimensional volume of space could be thought of as encoded on its two-dimensional boundary, much like a three-dimensional image is stored on the two-dimensional surface of a hologram. The holographic principle proposed that this wasn't just true for black holes, but for the universe itself. It implied that the information about what falls into a black hole might not be lost in the interior, but could be imprinted and stored on the fluctuating surface of the event horizon. This idea, while abstract, provided a powerful new framework. It suggested that the information wasn't being destroyed, but was perhaps being held in a place where it could theoretically be retrieved. The stage was set for a new calculation, one that could account for this holographic information and check if it escaped with the black hole's radiation. The question was no longer just if the information survived, but how to prove it. For two decades, the information paradox remained a theoretical stalemate. Then in 1993, the physicist Don Page, a former student of Stephen Hawking, drew a map for a way out. Mr. Page argued that if information is truly conserved, the entropy of the radiation escaping a black hole must follow a specific path. Entropy can be thought of as a measure of ignorance about a system. At first, as the black hole radiates, our ignorance grows and the entropy rises. But Mr. Page reasoned, if the information is escaping, at some point the radiation must start revealing secrets about the black hole's interior. As more information gets out, our ignorance should decrease and the entropy should fall. The resulting graph, a V-shaped trajectory, now known as the Page curve, became the definitive target for any potential solution. It stood in stark contrast to the straight, ever-rising line of entropy predicted by Hawking's original calculation. For nearly 30 years, no one could produce a calculation from a theory of gravity that reproduced the Page curve. In 2014, as a 25-year-old PhD student at the University of California, Santa Barbara, Ms. Engelhardt and her colleague, Aaron Wall, developed a formula to account for small quantum effects on gravitational entropy. The formula was centered on a concept they called the quantum extremal surface, an invisible boundary inside space-time. At the time, it was a piece of pure theory, a tool of great precision without an obvious application. That changed in the spring of 2019. At Princeton University, Ms. Engelhardt and her collaborators realized this surface was the missing piece of the puzzle. They applied the formula to an evaporating black hole and found something remarkable. Early in the black hole's life, their calculation matched Hawking's prediction, with entropy steadily rising. But then, at the exact moment the Page curve predicted a downturn, a point now called the Page time, a new quantum extremal surface suddenly appeared in their equations. This new surface was deeper inside the black hole and had a smaller area. According to the rules of their formula, this smaller surface became the dominant one to use in the calculation. When they used it, the entropy of the radiation abruptly changed course and began to fall, perfectly tracing the downward slope of the Page curve. This was a very dramatic moment, Mr. Engelhardt recalled. Everyone was working around the clock to try to figure this out, not really sleeping at night because we were so excited. The breakthrough was made possible by a powerful, if strange, idea about the nature of the universe known as the holographic principle. Its most successful mathematical formulation is the AdS-CFT correspondence, a concept proposed by the physicist Juan Maldacena in 1997. The correspondence is a kind of mathematical dictionary. It asserts that a theory of gravity in a specific kind of higher dimensional curved space-time called anti-de-Sitter space, or ADS, is perfectly equivalent to a simpler quantum theory without gravity that exists on its lower dimensional boundary, a conformal field theory, or CFT. This duality allows physicists to translate extremely difficult problems in gravity, like the information paradox, into more manageable problems in the simpler quantum theory. Because that simpler theory must conserve information, the correspondence guaranteed that the gravity side must too. Ms. Engelhardt's work provided the first direct calculation within the gravity theory itself that showed how it was possible. While these calculations were performed in a model universe, physicists expect the underlying principles to apply to our own. The new work shows that information gets out, but it does not yet explain how. The precise physical mechanism that allows information to escape the black hole's interior and appear in the radiation, what some call the reverse algorithm, remains unknown. Finding it is the next frontier. For Ms. Engelhardt, solving the paradox is a step toward asking even bigger questions. Her current work involves investigating singularities, points where space-time itself is destroyed, probing the very pillars of physics to see which ones might be flawed. A full resolution of the information paradox would be a major advance toward a complete theory of quantum gravity. Such a theory is needed to describe the universe's most extreme conditions, such as the center of a black hole, or the first moments of the Big Bang. Ms. Engelhardt's journey has come full circle. From a child captivated by a puzzle posed by Stephen Hawking, to a physicist who provided a crucial part of its solution. Her work and that of her collaborators represents the achievement of a new generation of theorists building on the foundations laid by their predecessors. But this intense intellectual life is not all-consuming. She talks about her passion for swing dancing, a hobby that requires precision, timing, and connection. It offers a counterpoint to the solitary, abstract work of a theoretical physicist. For her discovery, Ms. Engelhardt was awarded the 2021 New Horizons in Physics Prize for calculating the quantum information content of a black hole and its radiation. It is the most reputed prize in physics after the Nobel Prize, and is considered the crowning achievement for young researchers. In 2023, she received the Gribov Medal for her groundbreaking contributions to the understanding of quantum information in gravity and black hole physics. The work continues, driven by the same curiosity that started it all. As Ms. Engelhardt told MIT News, answering these questions is the ultimate motivation.